With so much of our water handling attempting to slow and calm water, is this counterproductive if we are installing devices to harvest energy from water? Well, we have a principle to stop, spread, and soak water, and that water is then moving through the system slowly, so it's much easier to store it with head pressure. Now we go for our high dams for energy and our lower dams full of life. That's the way nature works. High energy in water up high, lots of life in water down low. But that doesn't mean that if we've got a running stream, we're damming the running stream. We've still got a running stream running through the property, which we can use for energy. But if we don't have a running stream, like say Tuna Farm, it borders a creek, quite a sizable creek, at the bottom, but there's no creeks at the top. There's no running water through the farm unless there's very big rains actually happening, or we're in the rainy season when we've had a lot of regular rain. But with storages, with water storages, which are a very small part of the total water coming through the farm, we can hold water, and that water we could turn on. And we can use that water for energy if you want. Now that's potential energy that was not there before. And we've got 25 dams that we could do that to. So we've got a huge battery of energy in the water storage, which has been created by stopping, slowing, and spreading water. So there are continuous little gentle flows enhancing life in the system all the way through, but also now there's 3.5 million litres sitting behind this pipe, just on one dam. So we can switch the energy of the water storage on and produce, use it for mechanical devices if that's what we want to do.